Hey, what is up everyone, Norman from Future Tree University here. Welcome to another video in our Retrofit series. Now when working with Retrofit, you always have to declare a central base URL, and usually all endpoints are relative to that base URL. It does get tricky when you're trying to request resources on a completely different domain. Now depending on your app, maybe you have two domains you manage, but if it's completely random, it gets really hard. In this video, you will learn how you can make requests which are outside of your regular base URL. This is useful if you receive a full URL, for example, when you're trying to access a profile photo, which is stored on an Amazon S3 account rather than your own domain. As always, you can find the content as tutorial and also code snippets for easy carbon pasting on our website. The link is the first thing in the description below. Usually in Retrofit, you describe the endpoint. So you have some kind of method and you have the centrally stored base URL, and then relative to that base URL, you declare where the request actually goes to. And you have features like path replacement to actually change the URL depending on your needs. As I said before, this doesn't really work if you receive a full URL already from a different request or through a header. Retrofit offers an easy solution here. We can simply use, instead of a path annotation, we can use a URL annotation. We're still going to pass a string, but this is actually the URL we're going to access. So we can skip this, and we're also going to ignore the base URL. We can simply pass the entire URL, and Retrofit will access that exact URL. Fantastic. So let's try this out. In our main activity, so far we have called the get user profile photo with our username. Now we're going to change this now and pass the stored GitHub profile photo from our account. As you can see, the URL is not really that easy. Of course, you have the user ID, but you also have some random server account down here. So it's not really possible to use a regular Retrofit dynamic of base URL and relative endpoint URL to build the final complete URL. So let's see if this would work. All right, as you know, we are accessing a resources with a get request, and we're completely ignoring what we're entering here. So let's just add some nonsense here and start the request. Okay, our app crashed because I completely removed the annotation instead of just the URL. So let's try this again. So we don't need the URL since we're passing it dynamically, but we still need to clear what kind of request it is, obviously. Let's try this again. Add some nonsense since it doesn't really matter. Start the request. And it gave us a success message. Now, we're not doing anything with the image, so we are receiving it, Retrofit gets it, but we don't really display it or save it. This is the topic of a new video, which we will publish soon, which is download files with Retrofit. For this video, this should be enough. We have learned how you can use the URL annotation to access resources on a completely different domain than your base URL. This is super useful if you receive a URL from a response, from a server, or maybe from a header. Thanks for watching, like the video if you've learned something, and subscribe if you want to see more videos in this series. Enjoy coding and make it rock!